Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the third race of the NASCAR Amino iRacing Cup Series season. We are live here from the Charlotte Motor Speedway. Of course, just like usual, we have cars practicing here in the background. But first, we're going to be here in the booth. I'm joined once again by Cater Johns and Zachary Stern. How are you two?
I'm great. How about you?
I'm all right. How about you?
I'm fantastic.
All right. Well, I guess I'll get a couple quick thoughts. I'll start with you, Cater. What are you expecting today, huh?
I'm expecting a lot of 2-3 wide action around these not terribly high banks, but pretty good sized banks around turns 1, 2, 3, and 4 around here at Charlotte. Should be some good racing.
Zachary?
I think we're going to see some insane restarts, and I think we're going to see some moving around here on the longer runs here.
All right, well, that's awesome to hear. But first, just like always, once again, we're going to take a look at the qualifying pole lap here set by Carter Jones. Cater, do you want to take us through what qualifying is like in these two laps?
Yes, I will. So it's important you get off pit road with some good speed, not too much wheel spin. You saw him kick a bit of smoke up there. As he goes through turns 1 and 2, you can't merge back up until right there when you get onto the back stretch, so make sure you do that, or else you will be penalized. And then you get ready to head into turn 3. Make sure you take the appropriate line and get that good launch off turn 4, because it's a lot of the qualifying lap is how you approach it on your warm-up lap. You got to build up as much speed as possible. So you take the green flag right here, try to cut as close to the grass as possible. It's a quad oval style, so you want to get close to that grass. And then you get right there along the painted blue and white line along turns 1 and 2, and then jet back out to the outside wall, the typical racing line to try and maximize speed inside around the corner and then back to the wall, trying to use as much track as possible. Back to the bottom through turns 3 and 4. You have a bit more room there than the 62 did. Probably could have made up a bit more there, but nonetheless, he has a fast car, and he got the job done here with a pole.
Yeah, that's impressive. He's going to take one extra lap around. But, Leia, like I said, you know, you have these guys, you know, it's really interesting that they're going to be hooking it on that white and blue line. I feel like that's going to be key to, you know, getting a lot of grip, because a lot of drivers have said that the best place I think it is to be at the moment will be right there on that bottom line. Of course, you think some guys are probably going to make some passes up top. At least some guys are going to attempt to. But nonetheless, that was Carter Jones. He was on pole today. But now, cars are lined up here on the track. Let's hit trackside for the command.
Drivers, start your engine!
And the cars are rolling off the front stretch, ready to get this race underway. But first, let's take a look at the starting line. And cars are on track. We're ready to get this race underway, but let's look at the race analysis. 100 laps here, a little bit longer. The fuel window is about 38 to 45 laps, so around that range. And then the practice winner from earlier was Carter Jones as well in the 62. So let's get a couple picks out of the way first. Zachary, I'll start with you. Who are you looking at today to win the race?
It's hard to say. There's a lot of really good cars in the field. I think Justin Ricci here. I know I picked him last week, and he kind of ended up not having a great day. But I really think that he's got something here today. He's He's great at these kinds of intermediates, and I think he's going to have something to show the field today.
You see, I think the same row 3, but I'm thinking Ethan O'Connor. He told me the other day that he's almost completed with his Pokédex, and I think we heard today that he's actually finished that Pokédex. So I think he's going to be very, very going off that momentum to try and win here today at Charlotte. Longer race, 2 pit stops.
All right, and here they come. The green flag is out. We are underway at Charlotte. Carter Jones already starts off a really good jump. Zack Stern is going to slide into second. Caleb is going to just barely get in and slide to third.
Okay. Oh, Caleb up the track here. He's gonna hold on to the position. Are we gonna have a battle for the lead right here?
Oh yeah, we are. Here comes Zach to the inside. Oh, Caleb don't know where to go. Here they come off of turn 4. Who's gonna be the person to lead the first lap? It's gonna be side by side. It looks like Carter is gonna lead the first lap. 3 wide behind. Oh, into the wall. Oh, Caleb's into the wall.
Ooh, that's rough. Ooh, O'Connor
loses his momentum. Oh, there's a wreck.
Oh,
2 cars in the back. Looks like Sydney Allen, and I can't see who the other is. Sydney there, a little bit of damage.
Looks like another red car.
Back bumper. Oh, it's Brandon. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
That's gonna be an interesting dinner conversation right there.
Yeah, that sucks for the 2-car team there. Ouch. Well,
Brandon's got a ton of damage. Yeah, Brandon's got a ton of damage right here. That car looks like it might have a toe bent in. It doesn't look good.
All right, let's take a look at the replay here. They're side by side. There's Brandon. It looks like he's gonna try to get to the outside of Seth Peter's contact and just comes right up, and it looks like Dylan Jones and Lindsey Dietz got some damage in that as well. Yeah, let's take a look at another view here.
Oh, you see what happened right there? The 78 came off a bit from the bottom, and that slid up into the 83, who then just couldn't go anywhere but straight into the wall in the 57.
He's on board with Brandon here. Oh, yeah, that was a pretty decent hit there for Sid.
Yeah, that's just kind of the stuff that happens on these restarts. You know, these guys are pretty all over the place. There's a lot of people trying to make a lot of moves, and it's a narrow track here at Charlotte, and they just came together.
Yeah, he just comes right up into Sid. Oh, just nowhere to go.
Pretty substantial damage there.
Yeah, it was a pretty good hit there. Let's take a look at one more view here. Lindsey Dietz just behind Dylan, and he shoots up the track, tries to get underneath.
Yeah.
Looks
like he just like lost the nose. There's the air where he was is pretty much non-existent right here. So you see, here he is. Oh, there's contact.
Yeah.
Ooh, and he overcorrected to avoid Seth and just ran into the outside into Sydney.
Mm-hmm.
Well, here the car is under caution. It looks like a couple varying strategies already. Zack Stern, Caleb Marinelli, and Ethan O'Connor are going to bring it into the pits. And then there's other cars in that wreck. Dylan, Lindsey, and Sid. Looks like they're going to come and most likely repair damage. But again, a little bit of interesting strategy here. Ethan, Caleb, and Zack pulling it into the pits just 2 laps into the race. I wonder if they're having, you know, some ill-handling race cars.
I think
it's a strategy.
Because, like, I don't think you can make it on 2 stops if you come this early. But, I mean, it depends how many yellows you get as well.
I think it's a strategy play. We saw the 8 do something like this last week at Kansas, do it all a little off strategy. You see, he wins all the race off pit road. He was a little off from what Tanner did, and it enabled him to leapfrog the 24, who is the dominant car of the day. So I think that team might be trying something.
Oh, hey, how convenient. A nice, crisp, open Coca-Cola energy drink. Coca-Cola energy drink. Coca-Cola energy drink.
Hey, asshole. Look. NASCAR Amino Energy. Get it now!
And we are back here from Charlotte Motor Speedway. Obviously, we saw, just want to point out on that last pit stop, Caleb Marinelli obviously was on pit road for a lot longer there. He was obviously, I believe he was getting a little bit of damage repair when he got put into the wall on lap one there when he had that contact with Caden Bishop. But otherwise, he is back on the track. Maybe a little bit of right side damage, but not too severe. But here they come. Pace car pulls it into pit road, and the green flag is back out. Carter Jones once again gets another great start. Justin Ricci's teammate also gets a pretty good start.
I almost wonder if he jumped the start there. That was incredible there. I don't know. They might review that start, but
well, the rule in
green,
the NA
through the middle.
The rule just for everyone to oh, jeez. Oh, Caden almost got into the wall there again, but they are three wide. I'll get back to that rule change. I'll let everyone know what happened, but already three wide. James looking unstable there on the bottom. Tanner slides up a little bit.
Oh wow, there is not a lot of room to do this. Anthony Sasso in the middle.
Oh, Tanner losing a little bit of momentum up top there, but look up front. Here's Justin Ricci up top. He's going to get the pass complete on Carter Jones from the top, and here comes Quinn Yeager in a second.
There's a ton of top momentum. That was a ton of top momentum right there when they exited turn two. It was a line of 5-6 cars just trending around the 62, and now we're seeing it again here on the front stretch a little bit. The 29 and the 37 with a run up high.
And what you're seeing right here is that, these cars are spacing out a lot quicker than they did at Kansas. You see that top group is already pretty much single file here. And then you've got double wide here between Carter and the 94 of Evan Taddy. But they're mostly pretty spaced out as we see Quinn Yeager trying to go to the outside.
It looks like the 62 might be fighting a bit of a loose condition. You saw him trying to turn it into the corner right there, nearly lost it underneath another race car. But now you see a change for the lead, Quinn Jagger out front.
Yeah, Quinn with a great move on the outside. Caden Bishop is going to follow him. He's going to clear Justin for second place. And then you have a little bit of more side-by-side. Caden slides up a little bit. Here comes Justin back to the inside for second. He's got Brian Logano behind him, who's going to try to make some move on the inside.
And Caden's gonna, and Justin is gonna clear him back. Justin Ricci, I'm telling you, he has a car to beat today. He is flying.
Saw Anthony Sasso hold up someone a little bit. He's trying to paint the line, but I think was getting a bit tight or a bit loose, one of the two. And now you see right here, car is trying to get some momentum rolling on the inside, but still that run on the outside is ever more prevalent.
Back up front, Justin Ricci's back onto the inside of Quinn Yeager, trying to take the lead. They're side-by-side hanging in turn one. Quinn has that momentum up top, and it looks like he's going to clear him once again. Tanner Campos coming here in third place, looking to see where he can make a move. Justin tries to block Tanner to the bottom.
But you see, it's a lot harder to pass here at Charlotte than it is at Kansas. That's because there's equal amounts of grip and various sections of the racetrack, and you're looking here, these guys are able to just run pretty much anywhere and make time.
And I do want to point out the fact that this race, obviously it is sunset right now, and the daylight is definitely going to be changing. This race is definitely going to run, finish towards the nighttime. If not, it's going to be full darkness. So it's going to be interesting to see how the grip levels are going to change here. Everyone's trying to try to get all the positions they can early, and maybe some of them have their car set up for a night run. Here comes Justin on the outside trying to get by Quinn for the lead.
I almost wonder if a lot of those guys that came down during the pit stops adjusted because maybe they set up too well for the night, that it was just painful to handle at the beginning of this race, or they're trying to get ahead of the ball game and make those adjustments now, one of the two probably.
What I think was going on there with that set of pit stops was that those guys are aware that they are outside the window to make the whole race on one stop, but they were just outside. So I think what you're trying to do, they're not really up with the lead pack. I think what's going on here is that they are trying to save a little fuel here and try to make the rest of the race on one stop while the field in front of them has to make two.
Here goes Tanner to the inside. Almost contact there. Tanner's going to get a good run off of turn four. They're going to be side by side coming to the line. It looks like Tanner led that lap. But it looks like heading into turn one, a lot of the cars that are on the inside don't seem like they have the grip they want. Like, look at Carter right there. He's really checking up. It doesn't seem like... It looks like when they're beside a car, the air really gets them really tight, and they just have to lift so much more.
Yeah, the air has definitely been a massive disturbing factor with these race cars so far. It looks like we might have some three-wide action behind there. But meanwhile, up front, Ricci gets the lead back from Tanner, and he's going to pull away. Going back to those pit stops, I mean... I can see what Zachary Stern, what you're talking about with like the one-stop strategy. It just seems like a ton of fuel to save without much caution.
Well, I want to point out on those stops, there's Ethan O'Connor. He was one of the three that did pit there, and he has made the most ground. Caleb and Zach, who we saw a little bit earlier, they're a little bit deeper down in the pack, haven't seemed to made up much ground, but Ethan doesn't seem like he's saving that much. I wonder if he just wanted to get some quick race adjustments and didn't like the handling of his car in those first couple laps. I thought Paul was going to turn Caleb there for a second. Caleb, just like that again, he has to really check up.
You know, I don't think this that was a bad play for Ethan O'Connor with how much ground he's made up. He was about 6th, 7th. Now I think he's just inside the top 10. Not much loss if he's trying to gain a lot. I mean, he should be on the same sequence, essentially. Maybe he can go a lap or two longer than a lot of these guys because he pitted like 2 or 3 laps after these guys took the green.
And he has been the most efficient with his ability to pass. He's the only car I've really seen be able to make his way from the back to the front. Caleb is struggling, and Zach is struggling even more than that. So Ethan O'Connor came to play today.
He's in the 4th place. Screw the just inside the top 10. He's in the top 5.
And I want to bring up the thing that look in the top 5. Leland Fyfe is into the 5th position. And just keep in mind that he started this race in dead last. So a lot of variety, especially in this field. A lot of different players up front. And a lot of, like, look at Leland, a great run. And then back up front, Tanner's on the inside looking for the lead on Justin. He tries to fly. Oh, jeez.
Whoa.
Oh!
Woo. These guys, are teammates.
That's a teammate right there. They are raced, but they are racing aggressively. That's part of what this makes this team tick, though. They like to race to each other aggressively. And it's really worked for them. They won at Kansas in a 1-2 finish, and they're 1-2 right now.
And look at that up front, the Kylie Grider, with those two battling for the lead, she managed to catch that lead pack, and now she has passed Tanner into second place. So now, she seems like she also has a really good race car. She's trying to get up front and battle with Justin Ricci for that lead, as we have a lot of the cars are really, you know, still in a pack towards the back here, you know, really battling hard back here for position.
Still seeing some bottlenecks here and there, like you just saw the 8 of Zach starting to have to check up, slid up a bit up the track. I think because a few cars checked up in front of him, there was like 4 cars running in that pack with Zach at the tail there.
And what we're seeing here with Justin Ricci is something I really thought I was gonna see, but hadn't seen out of anyone else, and that's the ability to sort of just maintain a gap. No one else.
Oh no! Caleb Marinelli on his roof, heading into turn one. He's going to slide down the racetrack on his roof. What happened?
I think that late hit was from either Brandon or Sydney. Looked like maybe
I believe it was Brandon.
That was Brandon.
Yeah.
That was definitely Brandon. And, Caleb's car is killed. I don't think he's not able to move it.
That's interesting. Well, Justin Ricci kept the lead, so he is still the leader. Kylie second, Tanner, Leland, and Ethan is the top 5. So, yeah, really interesting. There's Caleb sitting, now he's gone. All right, so it looks like Caleb essentially retired the car, so that's pretty much that's it for him. A lot of the cars are heading into turn 3, catching up to the pace car, but let's take a look at a replay here. Let's see what happened here. Here's Caleb. Got the cars in front, a big checkup. He goes to the outside, and JD was already there. That was interesting.
That's exactly how you said it. Just a big stack up. Mm. And Caleb, I don't think Caleb meant to come up that high, but the car, these cars are losing grip as they run. So he came up, got loose trying to avoid them, and then he couldn't save his car in time to stay off the 93.
Yeah, you see that big checkup with Evan and Anthony there on the bottom. They had to really check up. Caleb, obviously, he went up to try and miss that because he probably didn't expect that. But then JD, I'm sure he did not expect the 15 to come up the track like that. Just nowhere to go.
Just an evasive maneuver by the 15 trying to move up and avoid that stack up. And then the 93 was there with a full head of steam. And what got that car flipping over was just this they were all bunched up against the wall. That got the right sides off the 15 with the momentum from the 93 pushing into him, sent the car over. And then, of course, Brandon hits him back onto his wheels. So thankfully, not going to remain upside down after that wreck.
Well, okay, let's see here from Caleb from his helmet cam.
I'm gonna be interested to see what kind of damage the 93 has. I think that car got a lot of aerodynamic disadvantage now, and I'm wondering if there's any suspension damage from being pushed into the wall.
Oh yeah, look at the hood damage. You see the hood come up there on both sides. So it looks like he probably has significant, maybe right and left side damage from that. Let's take a look at here from Brandon. You can see Caleb already just sliding on his roof, and he just doesn't get out of his line. Interesting. Well, besides that, we are back live. Here we are onto pit road, and everybody is going to come down. A couple cars that are staying out, but those cars,
except
I believe,
the cars
are all
in the back.
Those are all laps down, so I think those guys are just going to maybe try to get some laps back if they can. There's JD on pit road, so it looks like JD's gone a lap down as well, so... Here's all your cars on pit road. Let's see.
Yeah, you could if you're on the lead lap here, you couldn't stay out. It's too much grip has been lost at this point in the run.
You saw a lot of contact with the 37 and 62 on pit road, as well as maybe one other car that hindered a lot of progress trying to get into their pit stall.
And here they come off of pit road. Four tires for everybody. It's gonna be Justin Ricci, Kylie Grider, Tanner Campos. Top three off pit road. Well, under caution here at Charlotte Motor Speedway. We're going to head to commercial. We'll be right back with the brief. And welcome back here to Charlotte Motor Speedway. We are back just getting ready to go back green after the incident with Caleb Marinelli getting on his roof. He is okay, so that is good news to hear. But here they come off of turn four. It's going to be Justin Ricci and Kylie Grider on the front row. Pace car is going to pull off here. And here they come into the tri-oval, and the green flag is out. We're back underway.
Now, I have some supporting evidence that Leland might win this race. If you take the top three, it's the 12, 16, and 24. Well, if you add those three numbers, you get 52.
There you go. You never know.
Oh!
Someone.
That's
JD coming off the
road. It's just 93.
Yeah, JD's a couple laps down, so he's currently not in contention. But, Oh, Ethan. Okay. All right, now they're double file pretty much every lane here. Justin trying to pull away here a little bit, but they're double wide for quite a couple rows back here. And remember, everyone's pretty much on the stream, same strategy. They all just came to pit road a couple laps ago, so.
Yeah,
big run up high.
The strategy from this point on is really simple. You're probably going to come around lap 70, and that's going to be it. You're going to probably want to take four tires, and then you're done for the day, provided, of course, there's no more caution.
The only difference
because there is another caution, like say 10, 15 laps from now, you're not going to want to stay out on those old tires while everyone else leapfrogs you on all the fresh tires. Oh, there is so much stuff going on right now.
Oh wait, we got a car slow in the back. Car slow. We're still green at the moment. Who is that slow? It's Brian Logano, way off
Brian
pace.
Brian Logano.
We're currently staying green. What? I wonder what happened.
Do you have a flat tire?
Oh, caution's out. That must have been a result of whatever just happened there. I wonder if there's laying debris that the officials saw, and they didn't want to take any risks. But currently, once again, back under caution again for, I believe, the third time now in these first 30 laps. So I definitely say it's been very eventful so far.
I tell you what, this has been nothing like the first few races of this season. I mean, like, usually they've been keeping it pretty clean, keeping it out of incidents. And so far we've had a wreck on lap two between two family members and then a flip by Caleb. And then whatever happened just now.
Yeah, they are saying there was a flat tire for Brian. There was debris from that tire, so that was the reason for caution. But Justin Ricci is still leading the race. Just like Zach, I'll bring it up like you said earlier. Justin, he's got a really, really fast car. He's been up front for, I believe, a pretty much majority of this race right now. And he's looking really – his car looks really good.
Justin Ricci is just kind of one of those guys. This Charlotte's got this kind of super speedway pavement. It doesn't really lose too much grip. And I'm not saying that like Justin Ricci's not great with like tire wear or something, because there are some times where I've been impressed with what he does with that, but where he really shines is tracks where he can just rip it and rip it.
Ooh.
He comes down pit road.
Oh, very interesting. It looks like the field pretty much, I'd say it looks like they were just split in half there. This is going to be some interesting strategy here. Obviously, the top two, Justin and Kylie, bring it to pit road. So it looks like, based off cars that stayed out, Ethan O'Connor is the leader right now. There's Tanner, Quinn, Caden, Seth, Zach. They've all brought it into the pits here. Another interesting strategy here, Carl.
Ethan O'Connor, I mean, he was the one that took the tires on lap two or three whenever the caution came out and gained so much ground. Now he's going to be out front in clean air. We'll see how his car handles.
Your car's coming off the pit road. Not much of a difference here in the way they came in the pit road. So that obviously is going to be different from strategy later. But let's take a look at the replay here. Let's see what the cause of the caution was. There's Brian. He's three wide with his teammate Lindsay Quinn, who just puts him in the wall.
And it looks like that cuts a tire, maybe one of the rears, it appears.
Mm-hmm. And then he's just way off. No, there's Jesus.
I don't know. I think that might have been a front. He just kind of just went straight. He didn't really snap around like you would think of a rear tire.
Yeah, you saw how much he just turned the wheel to the left there, and then all of a sudden it just didn't seem like he could turn it. So, yeah, definitely
that's
right side. Anyways, we're back already. We're about to go green. So it's going to be, obviously, we got a couple different players up front. Ethan O'Connor is the leader, Paul Donlan second, and it's Carter, Anthony, and James Omaki in the top five. So it's going to be interesting. Those first three rows are all cars that stayed out. Justin Ricci, their first car that pitted, he is there in about seventh. Green flag back out, Ethan O'Connor leads.
Another big start there, I believe. Wowzer Cowsers.
And keep in mind, the rule in the NAICS rulebook is that there is no specific restart zone. Leaders discretion choice when they want to start, when the pace car pulls off. So, and just look at Justin Ricci, who just pitted there, and he is flying already.
An aggressive move.
Oh, and they're three wide. We've seen a lot of cars get into the wall when they're
careful,
three wide
careful.
On the tri-oval. Oh, jeez.
That's what Justin likes to do. He likes to grip it and rip it.
In more ways than one.
Up front, though, Carter Jones is taking the lead away from Ethan O'Connor. Paul Donlan there on the outside. They're still three wide. Here goes Paul to the inside for the lead.
Paul's an interesting prospect. We haven't seen him do much front running other than, I think, a bit at Daytona. But since then, like, he's been kind of mid-pack, very quiet. Paul Donlan's just a quiet driver in general. Sometimes has been involved in some controversies. And
whoa,
like,
James! Oh, my God!
James, Mocky, man!
And, I mean, just look at Justin Ricci. He just pitted, and he's already in the second place. He's on it. He wants to get... I assume he wants to get to the lead right away.
That's just his aggression. You know, that's what he does. He took gaps that no one else has gone to go, and no one behind him is, and look at that, not even a contest for the race.
It's looking to me like you got to get new tires when you have the chance to come down pit road when a caution comes out. I mean, look at Ethan O'Connor. It worked so well for him early in the race. Now he's fallen at least 10 spots, maybe.
Oh, they're three wide.
I don't know if it is new tires. I think it's just Justin Ricci is that good today.
Well, that and, like, to see all these other cars passing, there's at least 9-10 cars in front of the 28
JD.
Now. It's just such a big difference.
Ooh. I think JD got into the wall there a little bit. It looked like. Oh, they're three wide for the lead. What?
Oh, how'd that happen?
I don't know. Carter is now in the lead. Where did Evan and Leland come from?
Oh, this might get ugly.
Oh! Are they going to stay? Oh, they're staying through. Oh, James backed out.
That was not something I expected from James Omaki, but nonetheless, here they, wow, how
look
did they,
Leland.
Wait, oh, and look at him go,
oh my gosh, what,
these guys
the
are,
aggressive drivers in the series right here going at it,
hey, this is incredible racing,
I mean, again, look at what I brought up earlier, Leland, who started in dead last, is now battling here with James Omaki for second place. He seems like he's a really fast race car.
Kylie Greider, who pitted under that last caution, has not been able to go anywhere. And you see JD on pit road. Might be another issue with the tire for him.
Yeah, he's already a couple laps down, so it's not like it. I don't think it's going to hurt him too terribly.
I think we're starting to see the tires neutralize just a bit. A lot of these guys that were falling back now getting into...
Oh! Ethan! Oh, my God!
No!
Woo! Ethan may have been really lucky he backed off there. That was close.
Anyway, a lot of these guys that were falling back, it seems like they're coming back into it because of some tire neutralization and using the draft, utilizing that. Now we're seeing some players from earlier in the race that fall back on this run starting to come back up here, like the 28, until that happened.
And, you know, I want to bring up under caution, you know, we obviously had a couple split strategies there, so... It looks like when we thought, like, you know, simple strategy until maybe around lap 60, 70 or so, don't look like it's going to be that easy. So it looks like we may have some guys who are going to maybe try to, you know, split some strategies here and maybe pit it a couple different times. I don't think it's going to be too far apart.
Look at Anthony Sasso. He's up
look
to second place. He's on such
and
a run.
Where did he come from?
And he's on it, too. He passed Leland really strong on the outside.
Leland's struggling on that inside. I don't think his car is liking the tire combo it's on right now. He cannot make any ground on the inside. He is just falling back.
Well, yeah, nowhere to go. Yeah, he's just lost everything he gained. Oh, Evan's going to try to go up the middle. Yeah, Leland, no. His car is just not cooperating on that bottom. Ouch. Well, Tanner may even take him three wide here.
Oh, Tanner, don't do that. Don't do it, Tanner.
James is up into second. It looks like Anthony is stuck on the bottom as well. James is in second. Carter's up to third, and here comes Ethan into fourth. Meanwhile, Justin Ricci is just casually enjoying his time, you know, just pulling away while these guys are battling.
Yeah, while these guys are going, Justin Ricci is just, look, I'm telling you, he's got the best car here today. He is just on it. There's just something different about him today. I don't know if it's his confidence. I don't know if they just nailed the setup today, but... He's the only one who's been able to just get away from the pack when he's in the lead.
Yeah, it truly is incredible. As you see, the lights are visibly on here at the track. Justin Ricci really prides himself as being a pro hockey player with a fit. Actually, let's not go there. But anyway, he has a nice lead right now, at least maybe a second or two over the 62 and a lot of hard charging cars. But right now, it's just like he's in his own zip code. But now he's being caught.
Yeah, Justin Ricci is a pretty good hockey player. I heard he's really good with his stick.
That's a good one. That's a good one. And he's definitely showing it, that's for sure.
I mean, obviously we're talking about a stick here, because he is just flying on every restart.
Yeah, of course.
I will say, though, but now I think that the run has gone on here. A lot of the cars are spread out. It doesn't look like they're being super aggressive like we were here, that we saw early. Carter is starting to reel them in a little bit here.
And now you're starting to, and now we've had a lot of short runs, but now we're starting to see the good cars come to the front. You're seeing the two Tau Racing cars run one and two. You've got James Omaki and Anthony Sasso up there, who have just been strong all day. And then you've got cars in the back that are just making passes left and right.
Oh,
he's trying. He thought about it.
By the way,
yeah, he did. And Justin's trying to get it back. And meanwhile, these two are battling. Anthony Sasso's catching them back there in third place.
He is. I mean, he's closed it up to just three car lengths.
And I'll bring it up and say he's got a really good race car too. He's been up front a lot today. He just hasn't seemed like he's gotten to that lead point yet, but he's up front.
Carter Jones is one of those guys that I think just wants it more than anyone else. He hasn't won in a long, long time, and he just wants that win so badly because he just hasn't won in so long.
It reminds me of Brendan Gaughan, how he couldn't win for like year after year. Mm-hmm. Kind of ironic if you think about it with the car number. Now he's getting passed on the outside by Justin Ricci back to the lead here at
and
Charlotte.
He just flew right by him. I think Justin in that 12 car loves that middle lane.
He does.
Yeah, his car is working really well pretty much everywhere he puts it.
Ooh, Anthony has to check up a little bit. Here comes Kylie to the outside for third place. He's going to have to slide into fourth here, as we're just past halfway now, so now's the time where I think we can get, you know, to the time where we can think about a little bit of strategy here. Some guys are probably going to be pitting here, maybe about 20 laps or so. So, you know, obviously we had those cars who brought it to pit road under the latest caution. About half the field, Justin Ricci, one of those who brought it into pit road. So it's going to be interesting to see who's going to pit and when they pit. Oh, jeez. I'm telling you, these guys don't race like their teammates. They don't.
It's really
none of the Tower.
That's true.
Here comes the 88, the 28 up high. Try to get something going, maybe get around this 26. Right now, he's holding his ground.
And look at them. These two, there. I mean, I wouldn't say they're pulling away, but they're just swapping back and forth right now. Carter's trying to get to the inside, but not enough speed. Here comes Kylie, a good run off of turn four. She's bringing the rest of them, Anthony, James, and Ethan. Here she goes to the outside for second place. Carter's going to try to hold on. Oh, he's got to really check up. He's going to drop right behind her and Anthony here. Kylie slides into second, and now he just can't hold the speed on the bottom lane.
People wonder why Tau Racing is so dominating, and not just this series, but a lot of other series. And I think it's that team dynamic they have. Like, the boys have at it. Like, respect each other, but don't be afraid to use the bumper on one another, get side by side, get racy with each other, you know? And I think that's what really provides and just sparks a lot of success in the organization as Kylie Greider takes the lead.
I think
that's not something you see every day.
That's like that's one of the first couple times today that a Tau Racing car, not Justin Ricci or Carter Jones, has taken the lead today. It's going to be interesting to see if she can hold on for a lap lead. She's going to...
And Ricci's just right back there.
Nah, but she's going to hold it off for lap lead, so there's something cool.
Justin Ricci is one of the best defensive drivers I've ever seen. If you're passing him that easily, it's because he's setting something up. You don't just pass Justin Ricci.
Oh, Oh.
I will say another thing that I've noticed is a lot of those cars that stayed out under that last caution, like Paul Donlan and Ethan O'Connor, they've been holding really good speed, even though some cars pitted, like, you know, two laps later than them. I mean, it's just two laps. But they're still holding really good speed, especially Ethan O'Connor.
Yeah, I mean, like I mentioned earlier, they lost ground quite early on in the run, but once the tires neutralized, they've been able to hang in there and climb some spots again. So it's been nice to see. Is now the 62 tries to make it a tie 1-2 again.
Was that one of those crossovers by Carter there? Try to, you know, Kylie kind of blocked and then he just shot right to the bottom.
Yeah, Kylie tried to shut the door. She didn't want anyone getting to her outside, and Carter moved to the inside, but his car's been kind of struggling there all day.
I think what they're trying to do is they're trying to, you know, split up these two talents. Obviously, these two are probably the class of the field right now, Justin and Carter. And now you have Kylie in between them both, trying to, you know, not, you know, maybe have them not work as well together. So I guess everyone's goal now is to try to beat those two cars.
Yeah, well, it's not really working because whatever they're trying to do, they just keep ending up first and third.
So cars back in the pack. There's leaders who's dropping the ground. Kate also lost ground. He went up front early. Just didn't seem like they have it. Carter's back up in the second place.
And the 1-2 is back.
Yeah. Now it looks like, Ethan. Oh, good move there. He tried to fake James to the inside. He just shot to the outside. Now he looks like he's going to get two cars here. Good move.
A very good move.
Ethan O'Connor has just been really good today. Really aggressive, really sticking the car, trusting the car that it'll stick, and it's been working for him.
What stands out with watching this 28 here is that he's been successful on both fresh tires and slightly older tires. It seems like this car is just well balanced overall and is able to do whatever he needs to get it to do. No matter of strategy.
These two back up front battling. They're right on each other's bumper here. Carter to the inside. He's going to try to shoot it. Is he going to be able to clear Justin? It doesn't look like quite yet. Oh, Justin carrying really good speed up
top. Now you see that right there is the power of Coke Zero Sugar. Yeah.
You see, that's what I'm talking about. You can't just pass him. It's never easy with Justin Ricci.
These guys have been side by side for so long. Ethan O'Connor has joined the lead pack.
Oh, is he going to get by Carter too? Can he get a good run? Oh, he carries great speed up top. And Ethan to second place. Let's see if he's going to be able to get to Justin. Oh, we have Anthony Sasso on pit road.
You know,
I wonder if this is for him staying out early. I wonder if he came in a little too early. I don't know. It's going to be interesting.
You know who's been making me crap my pants a lot? That's this 24 car of Tanner Campos. He's trying his hardest to get up here with his teammates. And he's up to fifth or sixth. Make that sixth. And so
look,
is Zach.
Yeah, I was going to say. We have two Tau cars leading. And now Ethan O'Connor's leading the race.
Incredible.
A legit pass that he made there on Justin Ricci. Impressive. Good job.
All right, let's take a bet. How long before Justin Ricci passes him back?
I'm going to give him maybe two laps. Actually, no, I wouldn't even be surprised if he passes him this lap again.
I'm going to give him 12 seconds.
Oh, okay. I like it. Oh, look at the run he just got off into the trial. Well, here he goes.
I'm not kidding O'Connor.
And he got him.
Wait,
are they going to go? Oh, they're three wide for the lead.
Oh,
look behind. Here comes Kylie. Carter clears him and
That's not a move I expected from Carter.
Well, that was insane. Off turn two, it looked like the 62 was tight underneath the 28. They washed up a bit, and then the 12 got really tight, had to check up. That led to them being three wide.
Oh, Kylie all over the place. Look at Tanner. Guys,
I mentioned the 24.
This is something we haven't seen. Justin Ricci has fallen. He's down now into fifth place. We haven't seen him this far back.
I think he fell out of his rhythm when he ended up three wide right there. He couldn't quite make the pass on the 28 and the 62.
Oh, they're coming to pit road. Oh, okay. Interesting strategy. Again, okay, this is about fuel window. Fuel window open, maybe I'd say just a couple laps going. Look at this. James Omaki's gone. He's in the lead. I don't even... He's in his own zip code.
For now, at least.
Yeah.
All right.
I think
the cars hitting, you're going to start seeing more and more cars coming down pit road here.
Yeah, here comes James.
Omaki's coming in.
Yep. You saw him pull to the inside on the back straightaway. It looked like he came down. He's bringing Paul and Evan in with him as well. I'm going to say, I think Carter and Ethan probably are going to have, you know, the best track position coming up because they were one of the first to pits. And just like we saw at Kansas, the cars who pitted early really carried good speed. And here they come off of pit road now.
But here's the thing about pitting early. If there's a caution right now, they are in a huge trouble.
So Tanner's now in the lead. He's got a pretty decent lead
over
Kylie.
Not coming down. None of these guys are coming down.
I wonder if these guys are all in the same strategy here.
If I'm trying to catch the caution.
Here's the two as they'd cycle out. Carter, it looks like he would cycle out to the lead. Ethan right there on his back bumper. So they came onto pit road with each other. They came right off with each other.
So right now,
Justin Ricci, I think, needs his car. needs his pit stop. I don't know why he hasn't come down yet. He is struggling.
No one has come down yet. Well, the longest I think these guys can go is maybe like 77. I don't know how they could go any further than that. So give them a couple more laps. Here comes Brandon on the pit road.
If I remember correctly, all the cars that are staying out right now are the cars that pitted under the last caution. And Carter Jones and Ethan O'Connor were the leaders, but they did not pit on that last caution.
That's fair. So these guys are probably going to be able to go maybe two. Maybe I wouldn't even be surprised if they try to... it also depends on if anybody, you know, like, was saving any fuel. Technically, it looks like Anthony here is kind of the leader. Because remember, he was actually the first one to come onto pit road. And then these two came onto pit road a little bit later. But Carter, with a good run on the outside, he's going to get by Anthony. Here comes
Sid
as well.
I think the play these guys are doing, I think they should have came a few laps ago if they were trying to optimize their speed.
Oh.
But as you see, Ricci come down pit road. I think now a lot of these guys should probably stay out as long as they can to try to catch the L, but now we're seeing everyone come down as I say that. So
Justin, yeah. Lindsey, Brian, and Dylan Jones all have come to pit road. Brian and Dylan are a couple laps down as well as Lindsey. So they're... they're going to get to the inside of Brandon here. Oh, what is Brandon doing? They're hitting.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, now they're all coming to pit road.
I think that's their cue to come down pit road.
I think that's... Okay, that's everybody. Everybody's coming back down. There goes Carter and Ethan. They're unlapping themselves, so... Tanner's still the leader on pit road at the moment.
This is going to be interesting, because at Kansas, I would have preferred to come earlier, because there just wasn't a lot of time to get back around and get the lead. But these guys, they're going to have fairly old tires for 30 laps, so I don't know if I'd want to beat them right now.
I mean, even
I
look
think
at
I'd want to have run as well.
I mean, did you see when Justin Ricci came off pit road? He is way behind these guys. So if Justin wants to have a good chance of winning this race, he may even need a yellow. And there come all the cars off pit road, so Carter's going to cycle to the lead.
Yeah, those guys were definitely banking on a yellow, and they didn't get it.
You know what I'm noticing?
I don't think they necessarily needed a yellow to be in it. I think that the fresh tires that they're going to have are going to be able to pay off here.
Well, here's what I'm noticing. We are in the same boat we were in last week at Kansas. Tanner was one of the last to come off pit road. He was a really good car, and now he just came off pit road. I'd say maybe about like 8-lap difference between these guys. We'll see what an 8-lap fresher tire difference would be.
Here comes the 28 to the inside.
And the cars behind these guys have like 12-lap fresher tires.
That's James in third and Anthony in fourth. So those guys also came off pit road, but their tires are a tad bit older. So back here, Paul's in fifth. There's Evan sixth. Justin is back in seventh. And then there's Tanner and Kylie, two most recent on pit road. And then there's all the rest of the cars that also came.
So now we just wait and see how the strategy game unfolds, as Zach alluded to. It's going to be very interesting to see if these fresher tires can catch these leaders, and they have the time. They have over 25 laps.
Yep.
I think they can. Tanner made up like 5 seconds on Zack Stern last week in Kansas in 10 laps, and these guys have 25 laps to catch up. I think Carter and Ethan O'Connor aren't necessarily out of it, but they might be shitting their britches a little bit.
Yeah, but here's the big difference. Look at how far Tanner is back. He's only just getting into turn three, so Tanner is... He is really far back. Those elite cars are already just past the start finish line. So, and there's Shady on pit road again.
You saw how quick the leaders blew by Anthony Sasso, and
they did.
They didn't pit that much later after him.
Yeah, but also look at these two battling. James Omaki is now coming into the picture. He's gaining on these guys pretty quick too.
And here's O'Connor for the lead.
So by my math, Tanner's a bit less than half the track behind. That's about 10 to 15 seconds to make up, and they have 2.5 times the laps they did compared to Kansas. I think the math checks out. We might have an interesting conclusion here.
And I'm looking at these lap times. Tanner's the fastest car right now. He is the fastest car, so now it's just gonna be a matter of how fast will he catch him. I mean, look, he's caught Justin Ricci. He's on his bumper. There goes Paul to the inside of Anthony for fourth place.
Anthony's just going to have to try to hold on here. He's got much older tires than the rest of the field. I think he's not really in a good place right here.
But even if he's not in that greatest of place, let's give him a good shout out. He's run a really great race. He's been top five a lot, late in this race, and he's had good speed. It's just doesn't look like the pitch strategy is going to play out well. Up front, though, Ethan with the lead.
Omaki and O'Connor. And here's Carter Jones to the outside.
Here's what I will think. If these guys battle hard enough, and Tanner just tries, like Tanner, Kylie, those guys who pitted last, if they just, run their line, they're going to catch these guys in no time. And I mean, again, they still have a lot of time. Look, there they go. They're getting
made
by
up
Anthony.
A massive amount of time, though. They're on the same straightaway. They're going to catch them easily.
Yeah, okay, there they are, just getting past the start-finish line. Oh, Carter trying to get to the outside. Here goes James. He's going to go to the inside, go for second place. Let's see if we can find him. There they are. He's coming into turn two. And now we're going to go to a crank it up. Well, you saw it there and crank it up. These three, these guys are racing so aggressively. They've been swapping positions. And look, Tanner's there. Tanner's coming.
Justin Ricci there. Justin is flying almost as fast as him, able to keep pace. These guys are in trouble right here.
I wonder, though, it seems like their rate of catching has decreased slightly, and I wonder if that's going to get a lot worse considering how we saw the tires neutralize on the prior run to this. I wonder if we might see the same here if they don't catch up quick enough.
I will say, we haven't brought this up much, but I wonder if it's because it's gotten darker. It's almost completely dark out. There's still a little bit of sunlight, but not much that's hitting the track now. So I think the colder conditions... Maybe that's affecting these this tire grip now.
When it gets colder, the tires get grippier. I think the later it goes into the night, the better chance that these guys have to hold off Tanner Campbell. But
which, by the way, Tanner's about 2 seconds back. He's right there.
He's in that battle. They're not gonna have a fun time trying to hold him off.
And eventually he's gonna get that draft, and it's just gonna be worse for these top three. So.
And keep in mind, JD is not on the lead lap, so he is not for position. So don't get confused.
Carter blocks the bottom there. That gives O'Connor a chance to get underneath Omaki. Omaki with a big run off, though. He'll take the lead here. These guys battling, Tanner gets closer and closer and closer, and cue the Jaws theme.
I was going to say, this is where the Jaws theme... here comes Tanner. I will say, though, look, Tanner, he's caught up, but honestly, look behind. Justin and Kylie haven't really been able to keep pace, which is kind of interesting, especially for Kylie, who came to pit road with him. So I guess just not the same speed of car.
Justin is not surprising because he's got a little older tire, but the Tau Racing car, especially the 24 lately, has just been a different class.
Yeah, the plot thickens as the 24 is caught. He's there.
He's made it. And we only have we only got 13 laps to go. So yeah, now he's caught them, but now the question is, how's he gonna pass them?
He's gonna help O'Connor get around the Lockie. JD's gonna follow, but he's laps down. Now that looks like they might try work together and catch the 62 here.
He's now on the back bumper. Ethan a little bit here.
O'Connor is blocking big time. There's JD down pit road.
Okay, cool.
JD said on the radio that he's done for the day as long as Julie's there to give him a kiss.
Aww.
That's cute.
That is.
There's Zack Stern back here. With his hot start, wouldn't expect him to be the fourth Tau Racing car, but that's how it's been today. He just has not been able to get to the front.
I mean, just look at cars that have fallen off. I mean, Anthony, he fell off. I mean, look how far back he is. He's fallen behind Zach and Quinn, so a little bit rough for him. There's Caden. Oh, Anthony's down pit road. Oh, no.
Oh, man.
That raises an interesting question. Can Carter Jones make it on fuel?
I don't know. That's interesting.
He didn't pit much further after.
Yeah, but the max fuel window is about 45 laps, so I imagine they could make it. I mean, we only have 10 laps to go, so.
It has to be a problem, but if it was fuel related, that puts Carter Jones and Ethan O'Connor in a pretty bad position. 10 to go.
I will say, look, Tanner really hasn't been able to pass these two, which is actually kind of surprising. I think once he caught them, he's kind of leveled out with them.
I don't think he's leveled out. I think Ethan O'Connor is just driving like a madman defensively. He got to Ethan O'Connor, and then Ethan O'Connor just blocked him and mirror drove him hard. He just hasn't been able to get to him, and he just hasn't been able to get around him.
You can imagine Ethan is hungry for a win here. He wants to win in one of these series. And now here he goes. He's going to the inside for the lead.
That outside's been really strong, though. I don't think he's going to do it. Well, actually, he gets the position inside.
Where does Tanner go?
They're side by side. Let's see. Where is he going to go? He's going to go with his teammate up top. Are they going to get by Ethan? Oh. Carter does.
They're both
and Tanner does.
Oh,
he gets tight. Oh, almost got into the wall there. And now he's going to go back to the... No, he's not. I wonder
Campos
if that's it.
Does not want to finish second again. He is Mr. Second Place. He is done. He is finished. He wants to win. Can he do it?
That's got to suck for Ethan. I mean... He's just lost his position to Tanner, but he's still fighting
hard.
Tanner
on the high side. Is Tanner going to get the card? Carter shoves up the track.
Oh, here he goes to the lead.
Whoa.
Can he get him?
This could be good for Tanner.
Into the inside. Oh. Can he get him? I think he needs to clear him off of turn four. No, Carter holding good speed.
Carter staying with
a good run.
Where does Ethan go? Ethan goes with Carter. Oh, that's going to hurt Tanner. Maybe. I don't know. Oh, he carries great speed on the bottom.
He's hanging in there really well.
He is.
But he's not going to be able to hold on at all.
I think those fresh tires for Tanner have kind of... I don't know if it's working anymore.
Oh,
he's going to go... Oh, jeez. They almost hit. And with that, Carter's back into the lead. Coming to five to go.
Leland's on pit road.
That was another car that pitted early, I think. Oh, no, Leland pitted with the second group. Never mind.
Wait, no, I believe there's someone. I wonder if Justin Ricci came to pit road. I don't see him. I don't see him. I think Justin Ricci came to pit road.
Very
interesting. Oh, that's got to stink, though. Probably the best car of the day.
You win some, you lose some. Even when you have the best car and you shouldn't lose them, sometimes it's just how racing goes.
Well, we have four laps to go, and it looks like the winner of this race is going to be one of those cars in the top four. Kylie Greider there in fifth. Lost a little bit of ground. I don't know if she's going to be able to catch back up, but if it's not going to be James, it's got to be one of these three.
I think James is out of it at this point. He's too far back to make a move.
That is, unless they keep battling and Ethan checks up like that. Oh, Tanner can't get around him, though. Oh, Carter must be loving this right now. I think he's going to hope these two keep battling. And James is there. He's caught back up.
James is caught up. Now, this might be bad for the 62. These guys are single file, using the draft. They're going to catch the 62, assuming they don't keep getting tight in the corners, washing up, and having issues trying to catch. As you see, the 29 of Jagger tries to race the 8 side by side.
Good battle is also back here in the pack. Oh, there's Justin. I believe he, though, maybe, I don't think that's actually where he's running. Maybe a lap down if he did come to pit road, but I'm not even sure. But we only have two laps to go. And here goes Tanner on the outside. Woo.
The 62 have to keep battling side by side like that.
Cameraman, go back to the lead camera. Where are you? Go back to the lead. Hurry up. Okay. All right, here we come. Off of turn four. White flag is out.
It's another Tower Racing battle, and Tanner's there.
Oh, this is going to be good. Here they come. Into turn one. Tanner's going to try the outside.
To the outside. Could he go to the inside?
Carter's going to try to go up and block. Oh, here they come down the back stretch for the final time. He's got a run. Here he comes. He's going to go to the inside. Here they come. Oh, he got him. He caught him. And Tanner Campos wins. And Charlotte.
Wow.
Oh, my God, Tanner. That was amazing.
Wow.
Dude, Tanner just made up for the heartbreak last week. He couldn't get it done at Kansas, was beaten by his team owner, and now he shows his team owner, hey, I can do this against my other teammate, and he just showed that today. Great job by the 24.
Wow. That Tanner played that last lap beautifully. He just ran there on the back bumper of Carter, and he got a great run off of turn two, and he got to the inside, and I don't know if Tanner just really sent it or Carter got tight. I don't know, but he managed to clear him off of four. Impressive.
Tanner with that flair for the dramatic. I think he was with three laps to go. I thought, oh, he's going to settle in for third. He's not going to be able to get through there. And then he just flipped a switch and just started flying in those last two laps. Just an impressive drive.
It's moments like these that just really make up a series. And I think the NAICS has really established itself as just incredible. Like, the last couple finishes between teammates, the epic battles. Like, you don't know who's going to win until coming out of turn four. That's been the case with the last two races. It's just been so much fun.
I agree. The finishes in this series are they're something else. We had that side-by-side finish at Daytona. You had Tanner just fall short at Kansas, who made it just still an amazing comeback, and then here he comes. He essentially just, you know, repays the favor, shows that he is able to get it done. But that's going to wrap it up from us here in Charlotte. I thank Cater and Zachary here once again for joining me here in the booth. Congratulations, Tanner Campos, on the win. And let's take a look at the finishing results.